Hey everyone, today's video is my choice for top three watercolors currently in my stash, and also maybe an honorable mention. I'll put the timestamp for when the actual ranking begins.
I hope you're doing well. These are really crazy times that we live in. The craziest time I can think of that comes to my mind is sitting in a sealed room with masking tape, wearing a gas mask, which is what we did in Israel during the first Gulf War, when Saddam Hussein was sending Scud rockets to Israel pretty much every single night. And I know I'm like laughing, this was just really, really crazy. I was 12 at the time, and we didn't have school for like a month, and the TV was amazing. The comedy shows were so good during that time. They had a lot of stuff to joke about. That's the Israeli way. That's how we do it. We deal with humor when faced with crazy, crazy stuff. And yeah, after a month, they started school again because the rocket attacks were only during the night. And I remember I went to school with my gas mask, and it had like this plastic box that we decorated. How crazy is the world? So anyway, I wish you only good health, you know, listen to people of authority and do what is necessary. The kids are staying home next week, so probably no new videos. I don't know when I'll be able to record. I'll try, maybe they'll be kind to me and let me record some videos. No idea, we'll see. I'll try to record. Today is Friday morning. Yeah, everything is closing next week for the kids. So I thought I'll record this video. I saw a video by another YouTuber. I'll link you to her video. She has a much bigger channel than mine, but she was rating her top three watercolor brands, and I thought I would do the same. I thought it would be fun. I always love talking about watercolors. You seem to enjoy those videos too. And I'll also list below the watercolors that I have tried, just so that you know kind of what did not make it into the list. Because maybe, you know, your experience is different. Definitely there are a lot of brands that are available in other places in the world. I'm in Austria, in Europe. I'm sure there are a lot of brands that I haven't tried. So, you know, if your favorite brand did not make my ranking, then it doesn't mean that I don't think it's good. It's very possible that I just haven't tried it. Also, everyone has personal preferences, and that's why I'll explain why I really, really like a certain brand. And, you know, you can kind of think if that works for you, if that's what you're looking for. So hopefully you can understand why I chose what I chose. If you're new here, hi, my name is Irit. I do watercolor videos, mixed media, the occasional art supplies review and such. I would love it if you subscribed and joined me here. Leave a comment below and tell me what your favorite brands are and why, so we can all read and learn and enjoy. Give the video a thumbs up. It helps YouTube suggest my videos to people who might not be familiar with my channel, so that really, really helps me. And yeah, let's get to the good stuff. Yummy, yummy watercolors.
I'll start with the honorable mention, which is a tie between White Nights and the Aquarius watercolors. These are fantastic. They have really amazing quality. They are very affordable and becoming more and more widely available, especially White Nights. And I highly, highly recommend these. They have great sets for great prices. The major cons I have for these is that it's kind of hard to find them in another format that is not full pans, and that doesn't always work for everyone. And the formula is not super, super consistent. There are a few colors that don't perform as well as others. Also, they are not vegan, and for me that means I will no longer be purchasing them, but I highly, highly recommend them if that's not an issue to you. So you probably guessed the number three. These are some of my Schmincke colors. Schmincke is a very, very old brand with a grand tradition. They are made in Germany, and these are number three because, unfortunately, their artist grade line, the Horadam aquarelle, is not vegan. Their student grade is vegan, and their student grade is fantastic, but it's really, really expensive, and I can find other student grade that work just as well for less money, or even artist grade for the same price or less. So also their student grade is hard to find. You can usually find it in certain sets, so I can't say that I really recommend that. But their artist grade is, for me, I dare say it's unparalleled. The quality, the consistency, the formulation across the board, across all of their colors, even those that are harder to formulate, and other brands, in my opinion, don't make a good a job as Schmincke does, for example, with their cobalts, even though I don't think they have a cobalt violet that I like. But the other ones, they are truly magnificent, and their pans are spectacular, I dare say. If you've tried them, you know what I mean. They are luscious, delicious. They are made in a way that the paint is poured, I thought three times, but someone corrected me and said four times. So you get the most concentrated, beautiful, luscious paint when you buy their pans. Of course, the tubes are more economical, but the pans are just wonderful, and they are more concentrated. So if you like pan paint and you want to try, oh my gosh, this is fantastic. Now, again, sadly, like I mentioned, I'm not going to purchase any more Schmincke until they change their formulation to a vegan one. But I am a little bit anxious with, especially with one color, their Naples Yellow, which you can see, this is the row now that I'm swatching. I don't have all my Schmincke in an organized palette like I have the other two brands coming. So I kind of had to search around and dip into different palettes to swatch them a little bit for you. But the color on the left side in this row that I'm working on is their Naples Yellow, and it is like no other brands. It is so buttery and beautiful. It's a mixture of like four pigments. It muddies up other mixtures, but when you mix that with Winsor & Newton's Cobalt Violet, you get magic. Magic, I tell you. Anyway, I'm completely obsessed with that color. I don't know. I have a big tube that I bought a couple of years ago. I don't know what I'll do when it runs out. I have it in several palettes. It's just the most beautiful, beautiful Naples Yellow. They also have other colors that are really beautiful, especially when you compare them to other artist grade brands. I think they still are superior. Their indigo is beautiful. Their cobalt turquoise is lovely. That's my dupe for the Daniel Smith Sleeping Beauty. If you haven't seen my Daniel Smith dupes video, check that one out. They have a few brilliant colors that I think are probably not as light fast as their other ones, but they are, if you love bright colors, they're so beautiful. It's a brilliant purple, brilliant red violet, and brilliant blue violet. My favorites are the first two. They are so vibrant. You can see two of them here in this row. It's the most vibrant ones. So my con against for Schmincke, my only con is that they're not vegan. And I also know that they are expensive, especially outside of Europe. So moving on to number two, this is relatively newer in my collection, but it has become, as you can see, a leading brand for me. And I am talking about the Royal Talents Van Gogh watercolor range. Now, I know this is marketed in certain areas as student grade. On the Royal Talents website, I looked it up, they say it's suitable for student and artists. My take on this is that the entire range, I think they offer 70 colors or something, is made only from pigments that are on the cheaper side. And cheap is not an insult, it's just a fact. Some pigments are more expensive than others. And this range has a lot of single pigment paints, and then it has some mixtures that imitate more expensive colors. So, like an imitation of cobalt. I think they just mix, a lot of brands mix ultramarine with a little bit of white or something like that. I don't recommend those mixtures as a substitute for the real thing, but the other colors, like their single pigment colors, and also their lavender, which is just gorgeous, I love them. They really remind me of Schmincke, the experience of using them. The pans are beautiful. They are really creamy and vibrant, you can see. I really don't feel any difference when I use those compared to the same paints with the same pigments in my artist grade paints. And I love these. They are really affordable in Europe, really, really affordable, and are also available in stores where I am, which is near a town in Austria. So that to me is a big plus. I do want to also support actual stores, not just online shops. I know at Jackson's they only have these in sets and not in open stock. I also think Van Gogh offers really, really fun sets, which I really enjoy. You know, sometimes you just want to try a bunch of new colors and you don't want to sit and try to decide between 70 colors which one to pick. And they have really fun sets like the muted set and the natural set and the pink and purple set. Really, really fun stuff. I think the paint is beautiful. Someone wrote to me that I think they went to the factory where these are made and these have more binder than the artist grade. I believe it because they're so cheap, but they're still beautiful. So for me, going forward, I'm mostly going to be buying Van Gogh paints if the pigment that I want is available in their single pigment range, and Rembrandt, which is the artist grade range, also from Europe by Royal Talents, for the more expensive pigments. If you are in Europe and you want something more local that is vegan and affordable, I don't think you can top Van Gogh. They are fantastic and the price is just ridiculous. The half pans cost, I think, less than 2 euros, and then they have nice tubes that cost like less than 3 euros. They also have a few newer mixture colors, which are called the dusk colors, and those have just some black in them, but a black granulating pigment, and they're just really fun and lovely darker colors and neutral colors. I really enjoy them. And moving on to number one. Now, this is actually, I would say that for me, the Van Gogh, also in the future, Rembrandt and Daniel Smith are my number one because I feel for me personally, they complement each other. Daniel Smith is unparalleled when it comes to their color range. They have some unique colors in their range that I could not imagine painting without. They're genuine colors, they're Primatech colors, the one based on, precious stones and minerals. I really, really, really love those in my artwork. Now, my issue with Daniel Smith is the price. They're really expensive. I know they're expensive in the US, but they're really expensive in Europe. And also that I don't think their formula is as consistent as Schmincke and even Van Gogh. I've had a few paints that are, in my opinion, a dud. I can't use their cobalt violet, so it's not perfect. But together with Van Gogh, I mentioned Rembrandt because I've only used a few of their paints and they are completely beautiful, but I just haven't used them enough to say, okay, this is my substitute for the not so special colors, let's say, from Daniel Smith. But yeah, it's some of the colors that Daniel Smith offers. You can see a good representation in the Jean Haynes set. I think she did an incredible job with her set. They're truly, truly beautiful, and I really feel they take my paintings to the next level, and they do these things that watercolors do that are just magic to me. With a few exceptions, the formula is great. Now they're coming out with even more sets of half pans. Their first release of half pans to me was a bit of a dud because of the palettes, but if you just use their palettes to store your paints, then you're good. And the formula of the paints in the pans is good. They are a little bit more on the dry side compared to all the other colors that I mentioned today, but they re-wet beautifully. They are really lovely to work with. If you're not familiar with Daniel Smith and you want to test them out, they have introductory sets, basic sets of tubes, and then they also offer now some half pan set. I know they're coming out with new ones, and I really hope to test those out, even though I'm pretty sure I have all the colors in these upcoming sets. I want to try them out for you to tell you if I think it's worth it. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it was helpful. I'd love to know your opinions and your choices. I'll see you in another video soon. I wish you only good health. Take care of yourselves, and yeah, have a great day.